and into the forest. And so it then developed from there, as you see today, a big tourist destination spot. Big tourist destination spot, but also it is a big outdoor adventure centre as well here in Bethesda. So you can get all your outdoor gear here, or you can learn to do any kind of outdoor activity, whether it's mountain climbing or abseiling or canoeing, whatever it is. Called the Nant-Franken Pass. Nant-Franken Pass. Was usable slate for roofing tiles. The rest of it is broken up. Drive you up to the top of the old quarry on the hill, They suspend you from your legs and your shoulders horizontally. You could go up to 120 miles an hour. Depends how big you are, how heavy you are. When I did it, they had to put extra stones into my overalls because I was in danger of getting stuck over the lake.
Oh, jeez.
They don't weigh an awful lot. Great fun, though. I recommend it to everybody. And the oldest person so far to do it, I think, is 93. So don't think you're too old for something like that. Welsh-speaking town of Bethesda, built by the miners that worked in the Penrhyn quarry, which is not part. And I'll show you some of the original homes that they built for themselves, modernised now, of course. Wonderful buildings like this one on the left, this neoclassical building here. And that was originally a chapel.
Of the red dragon.
What's the significance of the red dragon? The red dragon of our own Welsh flag. We've only had our own Welsh flag since 1959. So quite modern, really. Point out these cottages first.
That's what I said.
They are on your left right now, and there's a date in the centre. Little plaque here. Lived at the same time as this warrior king, Edward I. and it was Edward the First that captured one of the Welsh princes. And so when he murdered him in 1282, the very next year, in 1283, he started...
This is a statue of Prime Minister David Lloyd George, who was formerly MP Caernarfon Boroughs and Constable of the Castle.